know, the company that's right in the center of this.
Absolutely, very much.
What are your concerns about how the legislation is starting to be implemented?
Well, I think implementing it is going to be an enormous challenge because what we're hearing is that the amount of regulations, the amount of regulations that are going to be written to implement this is going to be in the hundreds of thousands of pages. So I think there's an enormous challenge there. I mean, what I spoke to the group here about were kind of other issues that have to do with the increase in the national debt that this bill occasions, or this law occasions, the concern that people have with all of the new taxes in the bill. And I sort of spoke up at that level rather than getting down in the weeds in terms of implementation, which for a company like Kineticare is going to be almost overwhelming in terms of dealing with it. I guess part of the good news is, if there is any good news, is a lot of the bill, the bill doesn't go into effect until 2014. So I think we've all got some time to adapt to the major portions of this law, which is still 4 years away.
Now, you know, in the run-up to this legislation being enacted, there was a lot of back and forth with the insurance industry. At some points you were consulted, at other points you were kind of scolded more.
Sure.
What do you think is, you know, was your final input?
The health insurance industry was intimately involved from the very beginning because the decision was made at the very beginning that we wanted to be inside the tent, that there, we had some genuine concerns about what might come out of any legislation, but we wanted to be at the table. And we pretty much earned a seat at the table by taking that position. And I think that that certainly helped going forward, although I could not characterize the industry as being happy with the law in general. There are certain aspects of it we're very happy about, and not the least of which is the increased access that the bill will provide for millions of Americans. That's very good. But overall, what I call the big bang approach here is not something the industry favored. Too much, too soon, too big, too much regulation, too much bureaucracy, too many taxes. But we do absolutely support the fact that it should provide coverage to a lot more Americans.
Was there any other way to do it, though, because incremental reform hasn't worked in the past?
Well, I think absolutely. I mean, our industry fully supported doing away in the individual market with all of these pre-existing exclusions, medical underwriting, and whatnot. You could have done that, true insurance market reform, as long as you were willing to put in an individual mandate that absolutely did require that young and healthy people buy insurance also. And that those two components coupled together, I think if that had been advocated for and passed into law at the outset, we could have gotten it. Now the problem is that the individual mandate has taken on, has become a very controversial issue in and of itself, and you have the right very opposed to the notion of an individual mandate. That's these attorney generals that are suing the government for it. And even people on the left don't like the fact that you're going to force people to pony up and participate in this. So the individual mandate has sort of become toxic. And if it's not part of insurance reform, then doing away with the pre-existing exclusions is going to be disastrous for the insurance industry. We're not going to be able to afford to take on a lot of people who are previously uninsurable unless we have some way of mandating that we get the young and healthy people into the pool also.